Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create a large-scale smoke simulation using Mantaflow. If you haven't already, make sure you download the latest version of Blender, Blender 2.82, so you can follow along with this video. Another thing to keep in mind is when working with these large-scale simulations, they take up quite a bit of space, so make sure you have lots of room on your hard drive when you are baking in the cache. Now that that's out of the way, let's go ahead and get started. And since we're creating a large scale simulation, we are going to need a pretty large domain. So go ahead and scale up this cube. We're once again not going to delete it, and we're going to drag this up so it's sitting on the grid, scale it up, and then I'll scale it along the X, something like that, a pretty large domain. From there, we need a flow object. So go ahead and press Shift A, go under Mesh, and then UV Sphere. You can use whatever mesh that you want. I'm going to be sticking with this. Go into front view by pressing 1 and then Z to go into wireframe and place this in the bottom left corner somewhere around there. The next thing that we need to do is actually add in a force field to push the smoke over to the right. So press Shift A, we'll go underneath force field and then a wind force field right here. Rotate that and place it over on the left. For the strength and the flow, I'm going to leave them both at 1. I am going to be turning up the noise amount to a value of 2 so we get some more randomness in the wind. From there, we can go ahead and start working on the simulation. I'm going to select my domain, go over to the physics tab if it's not already selected, click on fluid and set the type over to domain. And you might notice here that something popped up, and that is because I already have a cache enabled from a previous blend file. Don't worry about this, this will disappear once you bake in the data. Next, we need to select our UV sphere, go underneath fluid and set the type over to flow. Since we're going to be using fire and smoke, I'm going to be setting this to fire and smoke right there. And then for the flow behavior, set this over to inflow. If you want bigger and faster flames, you can go ahead and turn up the fuel. I'm going to leave it at 1. If you are having issues where your smoke looks like puffs in your scene, go ahead and turn up the sample substeps and that will fix your issue. I don't think we need to worry about that in this simulation though, so I'm going to leave it at 0. Now for the domain settings, go ahead and select it, and the resolution right here, since we're dealing with a large amount of smoke and it needs to be pretty detailed to look pretty big, we're going to be setting this value to 300. That is quite a large number for a simulation, but since this is Mantaflow, it does bake pretty quickly. Underneath that, we can set the vorticity down here. This is the amount of swirls in your smoke and it will make it look a lot more random. We're going to be setting this to a value of 0.1. Another thing that we need to check is adaptive domain. This will really help improve your baking time. And then underneath noise, this is where you get into the crazy stuff. Here you can enable noise and this will add in a lot of detail in your smoke. You can see on screen of a simulation without noise and then a simulation with noise and you can see the differences. So we're going to enable noise and leave the uprise factor at 2 and the default values work perfectly fine. If you want to save this cache, go ahead and set that folder right here. If you don't do this, the cache will be deleted eventually when you close Blender. Another thing to keep in mind is the end frame down here. I'm going to be setting this value to 175, just like that. And then in the end frame down here, I'm also going to set that to 175. And that's basically all we really need to do. Now, once we bake this in, it'll look really nicely. So scroll up and also make sure you apply the scale on both of these. So I'm going to hit Control A, apply the scale, and then I'll select the UV sphere, Control A, apply the scale. Now select your domain and go ahead and click on Bake Data. If your simulation looks something like this when you try to bake it in, the reason for that is because it's taking the old simulation data and trying to bake that in. What you need to do is bake in a little bit of your new simulation and then come over to the right side and free this data. That will get rid of the old simulation data and now we can bake in this new one with this new scene right here. So go ahead, free it, and then click on Bake Data. If your simulation doesn't look like it did when I applied the domain, don't worry about this step. It's just in case you do have an old simulation that Blender is taken from. Go ahead and free all that data and bake it again. All right, our first bake is done. Now we can scroll down over to the noise and bake this in. So go ahead and click on Bake Noise and you can see down here, it's starting to bake. All right, the baking is now done and now we can go ahead and skip to a frame, like frame 30 right here, and we can see what this looks like. Not too bad. Let's go ahead and skip to frame 135. And once it loads, there we go. We can see this is what it looks like. For the material for the domain, let's go ahead and select it and open up a new window by coming up to this top right corner and clicking and dragging out a new window. Switch this over to the shader editor and we can see here is the principled shader. We don't need this one, we need the principled volume shader, so let's go ahead and press X to delete, then press Shift A, go to shader, and then principled volume shader right here. Take the volume and plug that into the volume of the material output, and then for the density, this is how dense the smoke will be. Let's go ahead and skip to frame 30 once again, and I'll press Z and go into rendered view. This is our current smoke simulation. It looks pretty good, but I want the smoke to be a lot more dense. With really large scale simulations, the smoke is a lot more dense because there's so much of it. So we're gonna set the density over here to a value of 100. And as you can see there, it looks a lot more dense and a lot more bigger. There's a lot more detail in the smoke. To actually get the fire to show up, we need to turn up the black body intensity. If we drag the slider all the way up to 1, you'll see that we do get fire, but it's barely anything. And you can't go any higher than 1. But what you can do is actually set this value manually. So let's go up to 100, and there we can see our fire is now a lot brighter. And now with the slider, we can go all the way to 0 and then all the way back up to 100 since we set those values manually. And that looks really cool. We're not done yet though. Let's go ahead and set up the lighting. For the lighting, I'm going to select the default lamp and change it over to a sun lamp. So go over to the lamp settings and change it to a sun lamp with the strength of about 5. I'm also going to close off this window. We're not going to need it anymore. I'll go into top view and I'll rotate the sun lamp so it's facing at about this angle. There we go, not too bad. Now, if we jump over to the world settings, we can set the color all the way down to black and we can see this is what it looks like. Now, I am going to be using cycles for this render because I find that it looks a lot better than Eevee and it gives way more realistic results. Underneath the film, we're going to turn on transparency and this will get rid of the background. And now we can go into front view by pressing 1 and then hit Ctrl Alt 0 to snap the camera to place. Select it, move it backwards to get the entire thing in view. Something like this. To actually see if your whole domain is in the camera view, go ahead and select it and go into edit mode. And as you can see here, it goes way up there. So what I'll do is I'll select the camera again and drag it back even further and up like this. And I'll check it one more time, edit mode, and that looks a lot better. In the render settings, I'm gonna set the render sample amount to a value of 40 so this renders a lot faster. And go ahead and hit F12 to render out a sample image. Here we can see what this looks like. And there we go, we have our basic image. Now let's go over to the compositor, give this a background, and add in the denoise modifier. To do that, go ahead and exit out of this window and jump over to the compositing tab. What I'm going to do is drag this render layers across, press Shift A and add in a filter and denoise right here. Place that in between the render layers and the composite. To actually see what we're doing, we can hit Control Shift and left click on the denoise node to bring in a viewer node. Press V a couple times to zoom out and then Alt V to zoom back in, and you can also hold Alt middle mouse button to drag the image across. To add in a background, we can press Shift A and go underneath color and then alpha over and place that here. Make sure the image is in the bottom input. And now this top value controls the background. So you can set this to whatever color that you want. If you want a green screen, or you can just leave it transparent by Alt-D'ing this and it'll just be a transparent image. Since I do want a background though, I am gonna bring this in, put that into the bottom input, and I'm gonna go with a dark gray color, something like that. And now that we've done that, let's go ahead and render this out. To render an animation in Blender, we need to go over to the output section and set an output of where we want our images to go to. Go ahead and click on this and navigate to a folder. Once you have found your folder, go ahead and click accept. And now we can save our project, go over to render, and then click on render animation. And we can see here it has started and the fire looks really good. And this will render out into frames and then we can sequence it out. Alright, there we go, that is our final result. As you can see, the fire and the smoke look really nice, there's a lot of detail going up and it looks pretty large scale. If you want to learn how to sequence all of those frames into a movie file where you can upload to YouTube or wherever, I will link a video in the description of where you can learn how to do that. So that's going to be it for this video, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this or created your own render or animation, I would love to see it, so make sure to send this to me at BlenderMadeEasy. If you are new to this channel, consider clicking that subscribe button to stay notified whenever I upload a new Blender tutorial. That's gonna be it, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.